excited about our trip today? Me too. Now let us first do a head count to see if we were complete, okay? 2, 4, 8, 16, 20. All right, we are complete. But before we begin, I'd like to say welcome to the beautiful Malang city, East Java. Time check, it is now 7:45 a.m. and the weather is fairly pleasant. The temperature right now is 28 degrees Celsius. It is perfect, right? Now I'd like to introduce myself and the host. My name is Ika Alfa Anabila. You can call me Ika. And I'm standing here officially as your tour guide. The driver for today is very professional. So please say hello to Mr. Rudy. Thank you, everyone. Before we start, I'd like you to know that our bus tour will be slow flowing. And there are some friendly reminders and also safety precautions. So please listen carefully, okay? Number one, please always be mindful of your valuable belongings. Number two, smoking is strictly prohibited inside the bus. And please avoid littering to take care of our environment. Number three, please synchronize your time with my time so that no one will be left behind. And now it is 7:46. Lastly, we have first aid kit in case of emergency. If you guys have any clarification or questions, please feel free to ask me or to Mr. Wu. Is that clear? Very good. So, we are about to start a very exciting tour. While we are heading to our first destination, let me tell you a brief background about Malang. It is the second largest city in East Java. Malang, known for its cooler temperature, the beautiful surrounding countryside, and the attractive street line with historical buildings. Set on the Brantas River, Malang is a popular destination for visitors, with a vibrant markets, park, and Dutch colonial buildings to see. Malang also has a huge historical story. You will see several hidden temples and relics, including the Singosari Temple from the 12th century, are scattered throughout the city. And outside the city, there are some stunning mountains and also a national park for nature lovers to explore. Now, as we are on our way to our first destination, please sit back and enjoy the view of the Malang city. Everybody, now we are entering Ijen Street. It is one of the well-preserved streets in Malang city. Beautiful, right? You can see on both sides that along this street there are many historical houses with a large garden built by the Netherlands citizen back decades ago. These houses' interior and exterior designs were inspired by the Dutch influence and was occupied by the Dutch in the colonial era. Somebody said that the scenery of Ijen Street is nearly similar to the scenery of the South French. Is there anybody from French? Of you? Are you agree with that? Interesting. Here, some of the buildings are still entitled in Dutch name. Okay, everyone, please look at your left. This is a public library. Maybe sometimes you want to go there. Okay, and still on your left, this is what is called St. Maria from the Carmel Mountain. It is a historical Catholic church, and the local citizens have been using this place for worshipping or other religious events. For your information, guys, that the area of Ijen Street was actually used for car-free day area. But since the pandemic of COVID-19, it has to be temporarily closed. Now, we are approaching Kampung Heritage Kayutan. Everybody, everyone, as you can see on your left side, there is a Kampung Heritage Kayutangan. This is a village that has existed since the colonial era of Dutch. Here you will see a lot of houses that were built in the 19th century and still standing until now. At first, it was a waste area, but then the Malang government changed this area as a thematic tourist spot in Malang that has Dutch heritage style. You will find a lot of unique photo spots and also antiques right in this Kampung Heritage Kayutangan. Alright, everyone, now it's time to go to the next destination. Now we are heading to the Alun-Alun Merdeka. Everybody, now we are are in the area of Alun-Alun Kota Malang. Did you know guys that there are two Alun-Alun or city square in Malang City? One of them is Alun-Alun Kota Malang. It was built by the Dutch in the 1882. It was first aimed to build the colonial authority image. To build that image, the Dutch government built a various building around this Alun-Alun with the colonial architecture style. Today, this place is a very popular place in Malang. People use it as a place for refreshing, picnic with family, and also jogging. And as you can see there, in front of the Alun-Alun, there is a mosque named Masjid Jami. And also, if you follow that way, you will see a huge monument. How is the view of Alun-Alun Kota Malang, guys? Did you enjoy it? Great! Now we will continue our trip to the second Alun-Alun, known as Alun-Alun Bundar or Alun-Alun Tugu. Alright guys, the Alun-Alun Tugu or Alun-Alun Bundar is the second Alun-Alun in Malang which has the unique shape. Yeah, it's round, different from the previous Alun-Alun, right? And as you can see there in the middle, there is a monument or Tugu. And that monument has a huge historical story. That was the first monument built in Indonesia. That was erected in 1950 and was officially opened by President Soekarno. That monument, when it was 95% complete, was destroyed by the Dutch because they considered that this monument is the manifestation of the Malang people's spirit. This Alun-Alun Bundar or Alun-Alun Tugu covers over 11 meters square. And everybody please look at your right. That building is the Malang City Major Office. And as you can see guys, that this Alun-Alun is surrounded by other buildings like Hotel Splendid, military houses, and old school, and also many more. Okay everybody, for the next we will go to Kampung 3D. At Kartanegara Street, we will turn right towards the Trunojoyo Street. Everybody, now I would like to welcome you in Kampung 3D. Kampung 3D or a three-dimensional painting village is one of the interesting destinations in Malang. It was built in 2016 by the student of Muhammadiyah Malang University. They remade this slum village into a very beautiful and stunning village. And nowadays, it became a very popular destination in Malang. This place has around 2,000 three-dimensional paintings. And because of that, many people come to visit this place to take a photo. Okay everybody, from this Kampung 3D, we will continue our trip to Panglima Sudirman Street. Okay everybody, now we are at Panglima Sudirman Street. The Panglima Sudirman Street is dominated by the military complexes. As you can see, along this Panglima Sudirman Street, there are two military bases. Okay, on your right, that is the Yong Bekam Tungkostan. And still on your right, that is the first artillery regiment Malang. And that's why many people say that Malang is a military city, because there are many military bases here, starting from the Army or Angkatan Darat, the Air Force or Angkatan Udara and Abdurrahman Saleh, and also the Navy or Angkatan Laut at Tanimbar Street. After the Panglima Sudirman Street, we will continue our trip to go to the W.R. Supratman Street. Okay, and we are now in the W.R. Supratman Street. As you can see on your right, that is the Lafayette Hospital. From the W.R. Supratman Street, we will turn right to the Legend Sutoyo Street. Okay everybody, now please look at your right. Look at this mosque. It's called Sabilillah Mosque. It is one of the biggest and oldest mosques in Malang. And just for your information, that the pillars in this mosque symbolize the date of the independence of Indonesia, which is 17 August 1945. Alright everyone, unfortunately we are at the end of our tour, and that was the last photo today. Now we are heading back to Politeknik Malang on Soekarno-Hatta Street. Okay, is there any clarification, questions or suggestions? Please let me know guys, and I hope you all have fun and also learn something during our trip. On behalf of English Department, I would like to thank belongings, and I hope to see you all again in your next trip in Malang. Have a safe trip and goodbye!